Alright, so another video has come, you know, now. It looks like where we left off, I was going to attack Tarsus. And as a side note before we begin the battle for Tarsus, or the siege of Tarsus, you probably have noticed that I haven't really uploaded any of the Octavian campaign, and it's because I haven't really been playing the Octavian faction for Rome 2. My reasoning for this is mostly because I am unsatisfied with the Octavian campaign. Why is this here? Right, siege equipment. That's what I'm building with that. But yeah, I am pretty whatchamacallit. You know, yeah, I just don't want to continue it right now. I guess it's really unsatisfying to play. Mostly because I don't have the archers. I know that's kind of like a dumb reason, but there it is. You know, that's kind of the reason I don't want to really play it. The other part would have to be the fact that the Octavian campaign is a whole nother campaign, and I haven't finished this one, so I have to, like, rotate between the two, which I really, I don't know, I'm kind of finding boring. I guess it's too much Roman gameplay, and I'm kind of bored of that, so I really want to just finish this campaign first and then move into the Octavian campaign once I at least begin maybe a different faction campaign. Number three, well, I guess this would be number two of the side notes, really. Crusader Kings 2, you may have noticed I do videos of that. More like, you know, gameplay, walkthrough things of that sort. But I have currently decided to cease production on Lanka, my Lankan gameplay, which is the Norse, where I'm playing as the Norse Norse character with Norse pagan religion, with the old gods starting line, but in the kingdom of Lanka of India. And I was gonna make the East Indies, but I decided to stop because I kind of don't want to play it anymore, since I found out the Charlemagne campaign came out, and that kind of gives you 100 more years to begin with, and I think it would be more interesting from there. But it was also the fact that I didn't really like to be fighting on India, to be honest. Like, how do I put this? It got kind of easy, like, too easy, you know? I had a decent amount of money to buy mercenaries if I needed to fight any holy wars, and then I could crush my neighbors because I had more troops than they did. So got a little boring there, but it was also the fact I don't like India as, you know, the region in general. I'm not saying in real life I hate that place. It's just in the game, I'm not very fond of it. It's really not my thing. Now, of course, the other part that made me stop was, of course, the whole non-primogeniture. Because I don't really have a way of going around that. I have to do gravelkind inheritance the whole way. And that's really annoying, especially when, you know, I have no way of conquering the land I need to conquer. But I guess the key point here would have to be I'm going to stop it. And most of it is going to be because of the Charlemagne DLC that I kind of just found out last night was a thing. So, yeah. I did take a little bit of a look at it, and it's kind of cool. But you know what? I digress. You're here to watch the battle or siege of Tarsus, and, you know, let's just do it. Currently, they have Thorough Spearmen, and I'm pretty sure I mentioned it in the previous video. They aren't really a big threat, the Thorough Spearmen. I don't think I'll be advancing to the walls with my city guards this time because of the Wait, why am I not? Oh my god. No, I had a dumb idea. Oh my god. My bad. No, I will be advancing once more with the city guards. I was thinking Median cavalry was gonna cut down my spearmen, and I'm like, that makes no sense. Just forget that thought, right? And then Eastern spearmen, like, thorough spearmen are okay. Eastern spearmen are pretty bad. Hillmen, they're actually decent. The main problem with this army would probably be the Eastern archers, and if I advance with my legionnaires and don't have any support from the city guards or my archers, the Median cavalry, which is, I believe, heavy cavalry, heavy melee cavalry. They may be shock cab, I don't remember. And the skirmish cavalry, the archers, again, slingers, you know, kind of a problem still. But anyways, let's get to the battlefield. Oh boy. I think what I'm going to do is assault like something like that, and then send something like this, and then you're going to be next to the gate. Alright, group 3, which is my legionary, are going to start moving forward a little bit, just a little bit. This is also, now that I think about it, the first, I believe to be the first, actually, the first eastern settlement or city that we will be fighting for. The first eastern city settlement we're going to be fighting for, and I'm actually really liking it. You know, the way it looks good. The buildings are very stylish and whatnot. Let's see, what hillmen? I think the hillmen are actually good against spearmen. I don't know why, but that's what I think. Another thing is, I'm not sure how armor penetration works in this game. Like, let me bring up melee attack, I believe it's supposed to be under. Or is it weapon damage? Weapon damage, there we go. Armor piercing damage. I don't know what that is for. But it looks like they're shooting arrows and maybe some slinger rocks or something at my guys. They're probably going to throw javelins soon as well. Man, these thorough spearmen do not fit in at all. Like, with the look, they look Greek, and then you come over here, it's clothing. It's cloth people. It's so different. I mean, it's kind of cool, though. Oh, shit, I forgot they can have flaming arrows, right? We might lose a ladder here, and that's not good. It's taking a lot of damage real quickly, too. I like the fact that these guys can at least protect themselves a little bit with their shields. What's this? Wait, what unit just shot that? Alright, so there's a scorpion and hillman. What? Wait, what? Oh, I thought hillman had slingers. Like, they somehow got patched to have slingers with them. You know, like, how the Romans use pilums. That would have been weird. I hope this ladder makes it more than... Like, this I don't care too much, but this I hope does. Let's see. They have already made it, so let's move up. Let's split these guys here. Let's move our legionaries, you know, forward, of course. Yeah, they're gonna make it. Oh, they should make it. Now, I don't know how the hillmen are going to fight against my city guards. I expect the hillmen to win, but I'm not entirely certain. Oh, yep, there we go. There we go. They can throw javelins. I knew they could throw javelins. Well, I thought they could, so I guess that translates to I knew. Man. Let's see. What are they fighting? They're fighting the slingers, which is not too bad. And the eastern archers, again, not too bad. And that is some whack-ass lag. Wow. Let's see. Also, can someone tell me if the... what is it? Loose spacing, which I guess in Rome 1 would be loose formation, still works the way I think it does. Like, does it work... like it would in Rome 1? Or is it completely different way of working? Because the only reason I'm using it is because I'm assuming it works like Rome 1. I'm actually surprised they haven't died yet. I think it's safe to assume it works, but I don't know. Alright. Let's get onto the walls here. One of our units is badly hurt. Oh god. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. So the hillmen are doing significant damage against the city guards. And I guess it was to be expected. I kind of figured they would. But I don't think they'll survive against the legionnaires. If they do, that's kind of bullshit then. Because they shouldn't. Also, how are you getting... Wow, you're getting freaking massacred here. What the hell? Well, Well, I lost my anti-cavalry squad. I didn't think they would die this quickly. What the fudge? What the fudge? That is some wacky stuff, man. Come on, legionnaires. Do your job. I'm going to try and send in more backup to help. Our right side seems to be doing okay. And because these guys are going to get pretty badly beaten, really. Let's try and hold them up with our legionnaires and move the spearmen back. We're going to hold this side with our legionnaires again. And we're going to advance with the city guards from behind them. This should sort of help a little bit. And then we're going to re-engage through the front once again. Hopefully this sandwiching tactic will work. On this side, it does not look good at all. These legionnaires are not... Yeah, they're not doing well. We need to at least bring another unit forward. So let's bring one more unit to the wall here. And then... I guess we also have to bring one here too. We're going to redirect you, and we'll bring you from this side, this unit to that side, we'll move this unit to here, and then these two will move up this ladder. Actually, because you... Holy God, advisor, shut the fuck up, I already know. I never turn them off. I know I should, but I never do. These legionnaires are taking massive casualties. How much did they even do in damage? 64, they actually did pretty well in damage output. Let's just hope they can keep going. We need to break through here, though. So I need this unit to... Come on, cut them down, damn it. Take them out. What is this? You have two of these units here. Uh-oh, what's going on? What's this? What am I looking at here? Put yourselves up in defense. Let's move ourselves forward. Let's engage. Loosen our formation there. These archers are getting crushed now, finally. Let's try and save our spearmen here. We're going to move them back. Because I need these spearmen to... hold any Median cavalry that come through. These thorough spearmen are taking some shots. I'm liking it. Liking it a lot. You need to... Yeah. Right. This legionary unit needs to push that way. This legionary unit needs to push that way. And then we need to bring our third legionary unit up the wall. 40% fire damage is not too bad. We now have our legionaries splitting up, so they shouldn't get too much of a flanking anti-bonus whatever thing, flanking debuff. There is some major lag for some reason. It's probably because of the fucking smoke, the smoking particle effect, whatever thingy. We don't need that many Legionnaires to be climbing. I honestly have no idea what the hell is with this lag. I mean, I'm running like 60 frames per second, so I really don't know what is going on with the lag. I don't know if you can see it on your end, but I sure as hell can on my end. It's really annoying. Ah, great. Now we have a thorough spearman there. Alright, let's bring one legionary unit to the bottom here. Hopefully they... What? Yeah, that's what I... Alright, good. They're using this, because for a moment there, I thought they were going to run all the way here just to get off. That would have been weird. I mostly want to just push these men off the point, because once we do that, we should be just fine. And what are they doing? Let's bring our unit of spearmen, and let's engage with our legionnaires. We're going to do a... fucking hell. Well, no matter. Actually, let's form up and then fire at will. These spearmen should hold okay-ish. Let's get at least one volley. Or more, I don't know. 82, 102, how's the fighting over here? This is going really bad because of those archers in the distance, yeah. Alright, let's engage that way. Come on, one more volley. Are you serious? One more volley, come on! I'm just going to charge them in like that. Screw it. Our men need to be relieved. Let's also bring one of them, another one down, actually. Let's move you to the wall. I'm going to start trying to go for a flanking maneuver. That is, I'm going to move these men over here. We're going to flank from one there and the other side as well. We have a unit of 34? Jesus Christ. We are losing men like crazy. My assumption is because of these archers. I might be wrong, though. I'm actually surprised they're not using their archers, though. Let's see, these... Yep, there we go. They're starting to die real fast now. Like I said, thorough spearmen? Not the best spearmen. They definitely look cool, though. But they're really not the best spearmen money can buy. Let's also bring all of our spear infantry that is left to the bottom. Let's move this legionary unit. Probably that way. Ah, man. These archers are really doing a lot of damage, I think. Yeah, they're shooting into our backs. We cannot have that. We're gonna... Where's the gate? Right, this is the gate. I'm gonna move you to the gate. Let's bring this Roman unit to the bottom. I don't think they're gonna go for that tower, so let's block off that road. This entranceway with our spearmen. Oh, Jesus Christ. Face the other way. It's too laggy when I don't face this way. I honestly don't know why. Oh, for the love of God, are you serious? Let's get these men this way. And let's get you up there. Oh my god. Fucking serious. Ah, the lag. Let's just run our legionaries through these units. I don't care if they take a few more losses. I desperately need them to enforce this this is insanely not... I mean, it's in our favor. It's just not as great as it could be. Alright, so you got in. We'll just use you to do that. Come on, move them through. Move them through. They've got 77 Thorough Spearmen. Not too bad. Jesus Christ. What the fuck kind of lag is this? Let's get them a move on. Distract them while you can with whatever you've got. I just need my Legionnaires to move through. Holy Jesus Christ. Move. And engage. Keep your heads down, you idiots. I like that. Oh, God. Yeah, our first... A few of our legionnaires are just far too freaking depleted. Alright, so they engage their archers. That's pretty good. But we need to hit the back of these Thorough Spearmen. They've still got a... 100-something? 100-something of them? Let's move the 23 out right now. Keep the 53 in. We have 117. It's about an even match. Let's engage this way. Actually, let's move these legionnaires the opposite way. Let's stop the march. We'll move the 24 injured ones in through the back of those hillmen, and they have shattered. It's fantastic. The 22 will be fine. Whoa, you are 33 units only. That is not good. We are going to engage with a larger group instead. Let's bring all of our troops forward now, because these walls are now ours. Or at least a good portion of them are. Let's see. I can see Eastern Spearmen on the way. Yeah. Alright, let's move our legionaries to the bottom floor, hopefully. They'll be able to defend. I also want you guys here, actually. And instead, move for the gate. Try and defend that. If they charge through here with Eastern Spearmen, they're dead men. Their Eastern Spearmen are still crossing from the hillside. Let's actually try and engage them around okay, here's one unit. It's a Thorough Spearman. I'm going to try and cut off the Eastern Spearmen as they come through there. Got a 56. They got an Eastern Spearman that way. Hold the center. How many units? 56. Right. Group up. Halt. We're going to engage. Thorough Spearman should be dead. Let's spread our men out a little bit. And then further engage these Eastern Spearmen. They are... I think that's a... Okay, Frenzy Charge. Frenzy Charge, that's kind of a waste, if you ask me. We're going to hit them from behind, because I don't see any of the other Spearmen. We only have one Thorough Spear on the walls left to kill. So let's move our damaged Legionnaires with our Spearmen. Let us also move all of our units in. God damn it. What? Oh, right. They didn't finish capturing the gate yet. Because these... Oh, no, there's two of them still. All right, so it's about, what? 80... 91? 91 troops? Roughly. 88, I think. All right, we were going to whack them. All right, let's spread our forces as thin as possible. It's usually not recommended to spread them like this, but, you know, it's okay. Let's just throw off a volley first to ensure we do some damage before our charge. And charge the Thoros, because the Thoros are more important. Actually, it might have been better to charge the Eastern, because that would have given us more room. But, you know, they instantly routed. It's okay with me. The Theros should now be routing. And there we go. Let me see. Does our general have... Yes. War cry. Or battle cry, or whatever the hell it's called. Alright, there we go. We now have three of our best units. We're gonna advance forward. The only problem that I can see, that I can think of now, is the cavalry. So where are they? I have no idea. Let's see. Come on. Break, break, break. Go, legionnaires. Kill them all. What the hell? Why is that opening? Whoa. For a moment there, I thought I saw something on the minimap. It was just the flag. I also don't know how they got it down to one flag point now. I remember this from the very early days when they were talking about Rome, too. They would have multiple flag capture points. Now, I don't know exactly what happened, but I knew the system did not work. I knew that... Oh, Jesus Christ. You're gotta be kidding me. I have to walk all the way up here to fight them. That's... Oh, God. It's pretty tough. All right, let's do it. Move all of our troops that way. And it looks like we won, yeah. Let's move all of our troops now. Oh, yeah. And I think we're going to speed this part up because it's just a bunch of marching. Well, I think it's a bunch of marching. How do I want to proceed? Proceed with this. I think we're going to group these guys as an injured unit. And then we'll proceed with the two. Yeah, we'll proceed with the two. So group four and group two will probably proceed near the same. Group 5 has taken some casualties because... Oh, Jesus Christ! Alright, so... Yeah, I didn't see that coming.
Our general is under attack.
Yeah, I know. Let's get our troops away. Let's pull the 6th group here. We're taking a lot of damage from the, let's do some damage with our city guards. I guess we're just gonna have to sacrifice them. Our legionary here, let's move you forward towards that point so we don't just take damage. Let's just halt our advance for here right now. Actually, we might be able to do something with these guys still. That is, sit here on the flank and fire maybe one volley before charging in. Should give us a victory. Let us face the sides that are shooting us with their arrows. You should probably just sit here for now. Just sit there. I don't care. You know, take a few damage. Let's fire some... pilums into the backs of these men. There we go. Wait, what are you doing? No, you, stop. There we go. Now we've got a rush of legionnaires into this thorough spearmen. One of our city guards is pretty damaged in terms of morale. Let's pull him back. And we will do a hammer and anvil. But this time... Let's charge with the charge bonus here. I don't think that really did anything, but okay. That's cool. We have a 20. He's pretty hurt as it is. So I'm going to pull him out. Where is my general? War cry that son of a bitch. Holy God. Wow. Wow, we lost like 20-something people there. This archer unit didn't take too much damage, though. That's good. Let's see. Group 2, pretty damaged. Group 3, fairly damaged. And group 4, pretty damaged as well. But this should give us where we want to be. I mean, get us to where we want. Let's start moving up the hill with our legionaries. Oh boy, this is going to be a tough final battle because of those towers. Should be fine. Let's speed things up once again. So that. Okay, so from what I can tell, they at least have the scorpion kind of units. Wow. City guard move fast. That's pretty cool. But let's move our legionaries forward. First, we are going to keep our city guards to that side. Let us move our archers slightly forward. Let's keep group 6 in the back, though. We will move group 3 forward, ever so slightly. Let's see, how do we want to proceed with this? This is the flag, so let's capture the flag here. Apparently it's from both of these. Oh, wow, that is some good stuff. Okay, so they're just medium cavalry. My bad. I thought they were shock cav for a moment. But they're just medium cav. Light... Ligish. I was like, light? I didn't know they had two different types. But it's just the one. Let's move our archers forward. I'm pretty sure we'll be able to hit them if we move forward. Not to mention, we need to keep our... Probably... Yeah, we'll keep our spearmen over there. Let us... Move as many units as possible. We're going to put them all on fire at will. I want to make sure this side is heavily fortified with our spearmen. And then we want to move our own troops over there. Let us move our general's unit and his cavalrymen forward as well. Now our archers... are in a good position, but it's unfortunate that our other men aren't actually in a good position. So let's move slightly forward, something like this maybe. Let's move number 3 forward like that. I just don't want their cavalrymen punching straight through our lines, because that tends to prove tends to be a difficult thing to handle. Our archers should have the range now to actually hit something. So let's hit the spearmen first. They're not really a big problem, but, you know, if we can kill them, that'd be great. God, I really like the sound of that. The projectiles hitting their wicker shield and the sound of the swords and spears when they go into melee. I think it sounds really cool. Our archers don't exactly have the best shot, and they're barely in range, these median cavalrymen. We're also not doing that much damage, so... it's a bit surprising. But I get, you know... I guess it's because they're facing us, and shooting into shields is not the most effective way. So, let's just switch targets into the cav... Because once we... take care of their cavalry, they are very weak. They'll be very weak in terms of an army, and the cavalry is more susceptible to missile fire. So, that's a good reason to kill him. He said something that I didn't quite get. Man, they're actually really hard. Did they do something with archers in the recent patch? Because I'm not sure what they did, as I don't read the patch notes too often. But it feels like their damage has been decreased. Or something about them has been decreased. Because these cavalrymen are not they're not dying as fast as they used to. Okay. Oh, what's this? Oh, they just... What? Okay. I will abuse this system then. Hold the fire. Actually, can we still kill him? No? Alright. We'll just reconcentrate all our firepower there. Alright, I think a better choice here is we move forward. Just slightly. Let's cover their advance as best we can with our spears. Let's spread our units out more. And let's move this unit here. Oh boy. Let's move them forward. Move them forward again. Damn, that was quick. Let's see, we can hit their general unit now. Precision shot. There we go. Should make them more accurate, meaning they do more damage. It should. Oh boy, now that I look at the time, it looks like this is a video in and of itself, again. A whole video. Once again. Not the best idea. I know this kind of bores some people. But, you know, it is what it is. And plus, I don't really feel like editing it. I feel every one of these moments is pretty, you know, a pretty good moment. You know, it gives you the full experience of the game. Which is what I'm assuming you're here for, is to watch other people's full experience. Or to just have fun with shits and giggles and watch people die. I mean, that you know, that's always an option. There we go. We scattered one of their units. I think we're about to kill their general. No? Okay. Whatever. Let's finish this up. Well, let's finish these cavalrymen up. I don't think the three are any more of a threat because we have too many spearmen at this point to kill the three last cavalry units. Man, this is really sucking up all the time. Just watching the horsemen get killed. Oh! They're doing something stupid. Or are they doing something smart? Oh, that's their general. I now know who their general is. I can never tell who their general is. I wish we had heavy shot. Come on, cavalry. Go, charge. Charge in. Eat our pilum. Holy shit! Whoa! I'm sorry, I didn't... Holy shit, that looked really cool! Holy shit! Oh, that was fucking awesome! Like, all of the projectiles just... Oh, that was sick! Oh, stop firing. They're gonna miss all their targets. Alright, everyone aim at the one target. Let's see how many arrows he can take. Alright, so three of them missed. And he's dead. Okay, that was pretty epic. That cavalry charge was epic. You gotta admit, that was cool. But anyways, this is the end of the battle, and I'll see you back on the campaign map where I think we'll wrap up this video. Alright, so the campaign map once more, and there's the kill animation against the Arakawiwasa thing. I don't know what the hell they're called. But these Easterners, as they would be normally mentioned, I'm assuming normally mentioned, in this kind of, you know, time period thingy-mabob. I do not need military buildings here. It is useless, so we will be deconstructing them. I did lose, in terms of troop numbers, about half my army. So it didn't go super well, but I guess that was to be expected. I mean, I did do it just for the fun of it. Especially when I didn't really need to. I could have brought my other armies in, auto-resolved it. But I didn't want to, you know, ruin the fun. I think this is more than enough to defend right now on Tarsus, so let us move the rest of our army forward now. Let's move you to attack Antioch, which has probably been the place of, you know, battle for like a bajillion different people, races, religions, and whatnot. Let's start upgrading some of that stuff from Ancria, or Ancria, whatever you want to call it. Our Samosata or something is like a forward outpost, if I remember correctly. But it did lose its cavalry unit and what looks to be one spear unit, which is quite devastating for my army. But they are replaceable units because of mercenaries. We also have an army up here. I have no idea what that's doing there. Let us look at the army tabs. How can I help? And we do have someone here. Let us... I don't care. Anything will do. I don't care. Let's hire an assassin. Assassination failed. That's pretty bad. Valor, I think, is the one. I actually don't know. Oh my god, I have a giant blob of stuff here. Let's see. The Lusitine. I think we need to take that. I have seen my next target. Let us move north and crush the Britons, or Bretons, or the Britannians, or the... No, I don't think you can call them English at this time period. I don't think that's right. I think it's Britannians, or the Picts, or the Bretons, something like that. Let's see, we have two in the Mediterranean Sea, two of these armies. Prepared invasion, of course. Can you only make... What? Really? Huh. Okay. Well, that's okay. I mean, early legionnaire is not the bad... not the worst choice. Do you not have any... Okay, so you don't have movement speed. I mean, movement speed? What is this? MMORPGs, man? No, not movement speed. Movement points? Let's see if we can't rally the slaves. I don't know what that really does for me. I don't think it helps. Probably just makes it worse. Let's see. Settlement captured. Okay, okay. Man, we are starting to swarm like Zergs, man. It's awesome. But, you know, that pretty much concludes this video. I had a great time, and it was really fun. So, yeah. I apologize if this is like an hour. I, of course, have not yet seen how long this is. It's probably close to an hour. So, again, I apologize for such a long video. But I've decided I'm not going to compromise on this one just because I don't want to be in the middle of something and just cut it off randomly. So, see you guys next time.